Use the Oracle Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud Console to create an instance and create a user. Log in to Oracle Cloud Infrastructure using the information from your welcome email or your cloud administrator. On the sign-in page, enter your account's cloud tenant name, then click Continue. Enter your username and password. Click Sign In. The Oracle Cloud My Services console appears. Click the Create Instance button. The Create Instance pop-up dialog opens on the Featured Services tab. Click the All Services tab. Scroll down the All Services tab and click Create in the ADWC button. Click the menu icon in the upper corner of the Oracle Cloud Infrastructure screen. From the navigation pane, click Autonomous Data Warehouse. The console for Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud appears. You can use the List Scope drop-down menu to select a compartment. In this example, the ADWC SQA compartment is selected. Although this console shows that no data warehouses have yet been created, if there were a long list of data warehouses, you could filter the list by using the Filters drop-down menu to filter the state of the data warehouse, available, stopped, terminated, and so on. Click Create Autonomous Data Warehouse. The Create Autonomous Data Warehouse dialog appears. At the top of the dialog, click the Click Here link to select a compartment for the data warehouse. Select a compartment for the data warehouse from the drop-down list. In the Create Autonomous Data Warehouse dialog, enter a data warehouse display name for display purposes. Enter the database name. Specify the number of CPUs for your service. Select your storage capacity in terabytes, and specify an administrator password for the admin user of the service instance. For license type, select whether you are using an included license or bringing your own license. Click Create Autonomous Data Warehouse. The Create Autonomous Data Warehouse dialog closes. On the console, the State field indicates that the data warehouse is provisioning. When creation is completed, the State field changes from provisioning to available. Once you have created the instance, download the credentials zip file for client access to that instance. From the Instances page, click Service Console. A dialog opens to sign in to the Service Console. In the Username field, enter Admin, the default administrative user that was created for your Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud account. In the Password field, enter the administrator password you specified when you created your service instance. The Service Console opens in the Overview tab. Click Administration to switch to the Administration tab. Download a zip file containing the security credentials and network configuration files to access your instance. You're prompted to create a password for the credentials zip file. Enter a password and click Download to download the file. Store the file and make note of the password. You will use the file and password later to define a SQL Developer connection to your Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud database. Now you can define a SQL Developer connection to the database in your Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud service. Click New Connection to open SQL Developer and define a connection. Specify a connection name. Enter the database username using the default administrator database account, admin, that is provided as part of the service. Enter the admin user's password that you or your cloud administrator specified when creating the service instance. For connection type, select Cloud PDB. For the configuration file, click Browse and select the client credentials zip file downloaded from the Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud service. For keystore password, enter the password generated when you or your cloud administrator downloaded the client credentials from the Service Console. For the service, select Low, Medium, or High. These service levels map to the Low, Medium, and High consumer groups, which provide different levels of performance and concurrency. Click Connect to connect to your database. Once you have connected SQL Developer to your Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud database, use a SQL Developer worksheet to define database users. Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud databases come with a predefined database role named DW role. This role provides the common privileges for a data warehouse developer. For detailed steps on performing the example shown in this video, go to the Oracle Learning Library and open the tutorial named Provisioning Autonomous Data Warehouse Cloud. Find out more at cloud.oracle.com/datawarehouse.